Hello, and welcome to Election Night in America 2024. We have the two-term governor of Florida, Ron DeSantis, facing off against Vice President Kamala Harris. Kamala Harris is, the vice president under President Biden. President Biden has refused to compete in the Democratic primary, and Harris, Biden's natural successor, has beat off all challengers. Kamala Harris, again, is the Democratic nominee. She is the incumbent vice president under Biden. She's a former senator from California. She is only the second African-American woman elected to the Senate ever. She was a 2020 Democratic primary presidential candidate. Her approval rating is at a low 41%, even among African-Americans, and the president's approval rating is at 43%. Ron DeSantis is the Republican nominee. He is the incumbent governor of Florida. He won re-election in 2022. If he wins this election, he will step down as governor since that would be only 2 years as governor. He is a close Trump ally. He is a strong critic of President Biden. He is Trump endorsed in the primary and the general election. His approval rating is at 42%. Not much higher than Kamala Harris, and Trump's approval rating is at a very low 33%. Now we have the 7 p.m. poll closings in Vermont, Virginia, South Carolina, Georgia, Kentucky, Indiana, and, coming out of the state of Vermont, Kamala Harris is the projected winner with 3 electoral votes. They voted Democratic in 2020. There's no surprise. We've got senators like Bernie Sanders, extremely progressive and Democratic up there. Again, no surprise. Coming out of the state of Kentucky, and its 8 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Again, this is a solid Republican state. No surprises here. In Indiana, it is too close to call. 11 electoral votes here. This hasn't happened in a while where we cannot project Indiana, it's in its first vote. Voted Republican in 2020, and only 74% of the vote is in. However, Ron DeSantis leads by 5.1%. This is a state that's becoming more Democratic year after year after year. Coming out of the state of Virginia, Kamala Harris is the projected winner. Now, this is a state that many believed would be too close to call in the beginning of the election, especially saying that Glenn Youngkin won the gubernatorial election in 2021, the Republican candidate. However, this was a state that was strong for Hillary Clinton in 2016. This is a very establishment Democratic state, and Kamala Harris fits the Virginia description, really. Coming out of the state of Georgia, it is too close to call. The victor is unclear here, and its 16 electoral votes are still up for grabs. This is going to be a very competitive state. Ron DeSantis appeals to these voters here because he comes from the South, he comes from the Sun Belt. However, Kamala Harris will turn out African Americans extremely. 87% of the vote is in. DeSantis leads by 2.7%. Coming out of the state of South Carolina, its 9 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Many believe that this would be another state like Indiana that would be too close to call for a while, saying that Kamala Harris is African-American, but DeSantis' approval rating here has proved to be significant. Coming out of the state of Indiana, which we had just called, would be too close to call, we can now project its 11 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Looking at our electoral map here, we have Indiana, Kentucky, South Carolina, many states for DeSantis and a couple for Harris. The electoral vote count right now, just include Maine there, that should not be on there. DeSantis leads with 28 electoral votes to Harris's 16. We now have our 7:30 p.m. poll closings in Ohio, West Virginia, North Carolina, only 3 states here. In Ohio, we can project that Ron DeSantis will win its 17 electoral votes. This state with many suburbs that have proved to turn out heavily for Ron DeSantis, even though this has been a battleground state in previous presidential elections. Coming out of the state of West Virginia, its 4 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis, no surprise here. And in North Carolina, and its 16 electoral votes are still up for grabs, it is too close to call. 79% of the vote is in. DeSantis leads by 2%. And by the way, that is a state that went to the Republican in 2020. Our electoral vote count now is 16 votes for Harris and 51 for Ron DeSantis. Now we have our 8 p.m. poll closings in Maine, New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Rhode Island, New Jersey, D.C., Maryland, Delaware, Illinois, Tennessee, Alabama, Mississippi, Florida, Missouri, and Oklahoma. One of the key poll closings of the night. Many states up for grabs here. Mississippi and its 6 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Alabama and its 9 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Massachusetts and its 11 electoral votes will go to Kamala Harris. No surprise here. In New Hampshire, it is too close to call and its 4 electoral votes. This was a state that went heavily for Biden in 2020, not so much for Clinton in 2016. Kamala Harris did not campaign here. And this could, you know, this could prove to cost her big time. 79% of the vote is in. Kamala Harris, however, leads with 1.4% voted Democratic in 2020. Florida and its 30 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. This is a major call of the night. Florida has been a swing state as long as we can remember. Even though Ron DeSantis is governor here, no one would project that it would go to him this early. But we can project that he will win by 10%. By 10 points over Kamala Harris. Ron DeSantis will win Florida's 30 electoral votes. Coming out of the state of Rhode Island, Kamala Harris will win its 4 electoral votes. No surprise here. In Connecticut, Kamala Harris will win its 7 electoral votes. In Missouri, this was a Trump state in 2020. Heavily, solidly, Ron DeSantis will win its 10 electoral votes. In Illinois, its 19 electoral votes will go to Kamala Harris. In Oklahoma, 7 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. In Tennessee, 11 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Again, no surprises here. In D.C., the most liberal part of the country, Kamala Harris will win its 3 electoral votes. In Delaware, the president's home state, Kamala Harris will win its 3 electoral votes. In Maryland, Kamala Harris will win the 10 electoral votes there. In New Jersey, 14 electoral votes. In Pennsylvania, a key state, 19 electoral votes up for grabs. It is too close to call. The victor is unclear here. 83% of the vote is in. DeSantis leads by 3.2%. This was a Democratic state in 2020. Maine's first district, so that, you know, that district on the eastern seaboard, the most populated, will go to Kamala Harris. This is a solidly Democratic district of Maine. That's 1 electoral vote, by the way. Maine's 2nd district, 1 electoral vote, again, will go to Ron DeSantis. And Maine at large, Maine's popular vote, will go to Kamala Harris. 2 electoral votes there. Now we have our electoral map here. Kamala Harris has 88 electoral votes, and DeSantis leads big time with 123. Now we have our 8:30 p.m. poll closings in Arkansas, and only Arkansas. Coming out of Arkansas, 6 electoral votes, Ron DeSantis will win. We can now project that Ron DeSantis will win the state of Georgia and its 16 electoral votes. That was a too close to call state earlier, but we can now project that Ron DeSantis will win. This was a state that Kamala Harris did not campaign in because she thought she had it in the bag. This was a Biden state in 2020, but it proves that you must campaign in all these battleground states. Now our electoral vote count is 123 for DeSantis and 81 for Harris. 9 p.m. poll closings here in New York, Michigan, Wisconsin, Minnesota, North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Kansas, Colorado, Wyoming, New Mexico, Arizona, Texas, and Louisiana. Coming out of New York, it's 28 electoral votes will go to Kamala Harris. In New Hampshire, Ron DeSantis will win. This was a too close to call state earlier. But Kamala Harris is not campaigning here, and Ron DeSantis heavily invested in New Hampshire. Even though it just has 4 electoral votes, he campaigned here like crazy, and it paid off. Ron DeSantis, unprecedentedly, has won New Hampshire. In Kansas, 6 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. In South Dakota, 3 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. In North Dakota, 3 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. In Nebraska's 3rd district, 1 electoral vote will go to him. In Nebraska's 1st district, 1 electoral vote will go to him. In Nebraska's 2nd district, this is the district in Omaha, Kamala Harris will win. It's 1 electoral vote. However, Ron DeSantis will win Nebraska at large, and it's 2 electoral votes. In Arizona, it is too close to call. The victor is unclear. 76% of the vote is in. DeSantis is leading by a pretty big margin, 4.1%, 11 electoral votes up for grabs there. Colorado will go to Kamala Harris. Its 10 electoral votes have been pledged to her. In New Mexico, Many believed that this was going to be a too close to call state. However, New Mexico will go to Kamala Harris by five electoral votes. Wyoming, 3 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Louisiana, 8 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. In Texas, the victor is unclear. Too close to call. 40 electoral votes up for grabs. Only 64% of the vote is in. However, DeSantis has a comfortable lead, a lead of 7.8%. That is more than what Trump won it by in 2020 against Biden. Minnesota and its 10 electoral votes will go to Kamala Harris. In Michigan, it is too close to call. 15 electoral votes, unclear victor. 85% of the vote is in. DeSantis leads by 0.3%. This is an extremely close state. Harris does have an advantage here, being African-American. She will really connect with these voters, especially in cities, and she is hoping that these cities will turn out heavily. In Wisconsin, it is too close to call. 83% of the vote is in, and DeSantis leads by 4.1%. 10 electoral votes there. Pennsylvania, and its 19 electoral votes, will go to Ron DeSantis. This was a too-close-to-call state earlier, but we can now project that it will go to Ron DeSantis by 0.4%. This is an extremely close state. Suburbs, like in Ohio, have turned out heavily for Ron DeSantis. Now our electoral map is shown here. Harris has 145 electoral votes to DeSantis's 200. It is a close election. Now we have our 10 p.m. poll closings in Montana, Iowa, Utah, and Nevada. Coming out of Utah, 6 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. Coming out of Montana, now Montana is a fairly liberal state for such a Republican state. You know, we see senators like Steve Bullock being elected, Democratic senators. However, Ron DeSantis has carried the state, and it's 4 electoral votes. Sorry about that. Iowa, Ron DeSantis will win Iowa 6 electoral votes. In Nevada, the victor is unclear. It is too close to call. 6 electoral votes still up for grabs. 91% of the vote is in, and DeSantis leads by 0.5%. This was a Biden state in 2020. Now we have our electoral vote count. DeSantis still leads with 212 electoral votes to Harris's 145. Now we have our 11 p.m. poll closings in Idaho, Oregon, Washington, California, and Hawaii. Coming out of Idaho, 4 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. No surprise here, this was Trump's state in 2020. In Oregon, it's 8 electoral votes. Trump did make this a likely Clinton state in 2016, however, went solidly for Biden in 2020. Kamala Harris was expected to win here, and it's 8 electoral votes. Coming out of Washington, very liberal state, 12 electoral votes will go to Kamala Harris. In California, this is a huge win for the Democrats. It was expected to go to them, but now their electoral vote has skyrocketed. California, 54 electoral votes will go to Kamala Harris. This is Kamala Harris's home state, solid Democratic state, no surprise here. Out of Hawaii, Kamala Harris will win its 4 electoral votes. In Texas, this is a big win for the Democrats. Texas is no longer too close to call. Its 40 electoral votes will go to Ron DeSantis. He is the projected winner here. Now, here is our electoral map. Ron DeSantis still leads with 254 electoral votes to Harris's 223. It is a very close election, but still Ron DeSantis, he doesn't have enough to win. And again, 270 electoral votes are needed to win. 270 to win. Now we have our 1 a.m. poll closings in Alaska. Alaska, as expected, will go to Ron DeSantis. Out of Michigan, this is a huge call. Michigan will go to Kamala Harris. Kamala Harris needed the state so badly. Ron DeSantis is on the verge of victory. Kamala Harris needed the state. And now here's our electoral vote count. Harris with 239 to DeSantis's 257. It is so close. DeSantis needs 13 electoral votes more to win. Coming out of North Carolina, another huge win for the Harris campaign. This is putting more hope in the Vice President Harris campaign. Kamala Harris is the projected winner, and it's 15 electoral votes. This is putting her back in the race. She lost Georgia, but she picked up North Carolina. She heavily invested in North Carolina because she knew that she could flip North Carolina. This was a Trump state in 2020, but even though she lost Georgia, she won North Carolina, and she won big. In Arizona, Ron DeSantis is the projected winner here, and it's 11 electoral votes. He just needs a few more electoral votes for victory. In Nevada, Kamala Harris is the winner. This would not have put DeSantis over the top. Kamala Harris needed this so badly. In Wisconsin, Ron DeSantis has carried its 10 electoral votes. This was a too close to call state earlier, but we can now project that it will go to Ron DeSantis. The rural areas in the state like Wisconsin are turning out heavily for DeSantis, even though he comes from way down south in the state of Florida. They choose him over Vice President Harris. And Wisconsin has done it, Americans. Ron DeSantis, the governor of Florida, has been elected the president of the United States of America. He has reached 278 electoral votes, just 8 more than the mandatory 270. Again, Ron DeSantis has been elected the president. Wisconsin has done it. Here is our electoral map. Ron DeSantis has won with 278 electoral votes to Vice President Harris's 260. We see this is our map here. Ron DeSantis has flipped Arizona, Wisconsin, and Pennsylvania, and Georgia. However, Harris did flip North Carolina, and she so critically hung on to Nevada and Michigan. Again, families and suburbs have turned out heavily for Ron DeSantis. Those who don't approve of the president are turning out heavily for Ron DeSantis, and Ron DeSantis has won this election. Harris's biggest mistake here was not campaigning in states that Biden just won narrowly in 2020. I mean, we look at Georgia and North Carolina, it'd be smarter to, again, invest in Georgia because it has one more electoral vote than in North Carolina. But instead, she invested in North Carolina, and that, I'm not saying that one electoral vote cost her. However, but, you know, in states like North Carolina, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, Arizona, these are states that she could have won and that she should have campaigned here and that she could have improved on in these states. She really didn't even need North Carolina. I mean, if she focused on these other states, it would have been, you know, out of reach. And that would have been okay if she really invested in that Sun Belt and hung on to Georgia. I'm sorry, not Sun Belt, Rust Belt. So, as we end the night, Ron DeSantis has been elected president with 278 electoral votes.